Hello students, welcome to the video class for the subject Basic Electrical Engineering, and this video class is for first semester Diploma Engineering students. So today we will start with AC fundamental. So under AC fundamental we will study about the generation of alternating EMF and definition of amplitude, instantaneous value of the alternating EMF, cycle, time period, frequency, phase angle, phase difference. These are all we study under this AC fundamental. Okay, so let's begin with the generation of alternating EMF, means alternating voltage, and also we will study about the generation of alternating current. Okay, so see, alternating voltage may be generated by rotating a coil in a magnetic field. This is a coil. See here, this one is the coil. This part is the coil. This is the coil. Okay, this is the coil. So alternating voltage may be generated by rotating a coil in a magnetic field, and magnetic field is this. This is the N north pole of the magnet. This is the south pole of the magnet. So these arrow marks given here. These are all the magnetic field. Okay. So another way is by rotating a magnetic field within a stationary coil. So in this case, here this is a stationary coil. This is a part of the stator of the machine, DC machine. This part we will study later, but just now you know that this is a stator frame, and here coils are present, and this is a rotor. In the rotor here, north pole, south pole, and this is rotated inside this. So here magnetic field rotating within a stationary coil. Okay, so this is the case. Okay, so the value of the voltage generated depends in each case on the number of turns in the coil, or strength of the field, and the speed at which the coil or magnetic field rotates. So the voltage generated depends on the number of coils, the number of turns in the coil, and the strength of the field, and the speed at which the coil or magnetic field rotates. So alternating voltage may be generated in either two ways shown above. This is one way and this is another way. In any way we can study how the alternating voltage may be generated. So but the rotating magnetic field method is the one which is mostly used. Okay, so let's see equation of the alternating voltage and current. How to find out the equation of the alternating voltage and current? So consider a rectangular coil. This is a rectangular coil drawn here, having n number of turns, rotating in a uniform magnetic field. So see here, these are the uniform magnetic field drawn over here. In the magnetic field lines are in parallel with the y axis, and this is x axis, and this part is the coil. Okay, so consider a rectangular coil having n number of turns, rotating in a uniform magnetic field with an angular velocity of omega radian per second. So it is rotating. Here the coil is rotating in omega radian per second. Okay, so let time be measured from the x-axis. This is the time axis. X-axis is the time axis. Okay, so maximum flux phi m is linked with the coil when its plane coincides with the x-axis. Okay, so maximum flux linked with the coil when maximum flux link with this coil, that means when the coil is when the plane of the coil coincide with x axis, at that moment maximum flux link with the coil. That means when this coil is like in a horizontal plane, then only the maximum flux link with the coil. But now our coil position is like this, it is theta angle with the x axis. Okay, it's rotating in a angular velocity omega radian per second. Okay, so in time t second, this coil rotates through an angle theta is equal to omega t. So here in time t second, coil is rotating from this to this position with an angle theta. Theta is equal to omega t. Okay, so in this deflected position, the components of the flux which is perpendicular to the plane of the coil is phi is equal to phi m cos omega t. So in this position, the component of the flux which is perpendicular to the coil is phi m cos omega t. This is the component, this dotted line, okay, which is perpendicular to the coil. So here flux linkages of the coil at any time are n phi, that is equal to n phi m cos omega t. So the overall or the total flux linkages of the coil at any time, we can find that n phi, that is equal to n is equal to number of turns, phi is equal to here our phi m cos omega t, that is n phi m cos omega t. So according to Faraday's law electromagnetic induction, according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, the EMF induced in the coil is given by rate of change of flux linkages of the coil. Okay, so this is the statement of the Faraday law of electromagnetic induction, that the EMF induced in the coil is given by the rate of change of flux linkages of the coil. Okay, so hence the value of the induced EMF at this instant when theta is equal to omega t, or the instantaneous value of the induced EMF given by E is equal to minus d by dt n phi volt. Volt is the unit of voltage. That is equal to minus n d by d phi. In place of phi, we can put phi m cos omega t. So here it is minus n is the constant term. So minus n, and phi m is also maximum phi. It is also constant. It is also shift to the left side. Then the derivative of cos omega t. Derivative of cos omega t is the minus sin omega t. And then omega t, for omega t, derivative is omega. So minus n phi m omega, then minus sin omega t. So minus minus plus. So omega n phi m sin omega, it is omega t actually, okay, omega t. Then omega n phi m sin theta volt, we can write in this way also. This is our instantaneous value of the induced EMF. So when the coil has turned through 90 degree, that means when theta is equal to 90 degree, then sin theta is equal to 1. So hence E has maximum value, say EM. That means when sin theta is equal to 1, then E is equal to what? Omega n phi m. This is the maximum value. So we can notify this total term as EM. So EM is equal to omega n phi m. Or you can write omega n phi m is the bm into a, okay, and that is equal to 2 pi f n bm into a. Bm is the maximum flux density in Weber per meter square, then a is equal to area of the coil in meter square. So frequency f is equal to frequency of rotation of the coil in revolution per second. So we can write finally this E expression as E is equal to this all terms omega n phi m replaced by capital EM. This is written over here. So E is equal to EM sin theta or EM sin omega t. Similarly, the equation of induced alternating current is equal to I is equal to IM sin omega t. Okay. So provided the coil circuit has been closed through a resistive load. Actually, in case of resistive load only, the current and voltage value are same because they both are in a same phase. We will study this properties of resistor, resistive load, inductive load, capacitive load later. Okay, so since omega is equal to 2 pi f, where f is the frequency of rotation of coil, so the above equation, that means E, equation voltage and current can be written as E is equal to Em sin omega t. In place of omega, we can put 2 pi f. So Em sin 2 pi f t. So in place of f, we can write 1 by t. That is equal to frequency is equal to actually, frequency is equal to, we can write 1 by t. Or we can write t is equal to 1 by f. Okay, so t is the time period of the alternating voltage or current. So t is equal to 1 by f, or f is equal to 1 by t. That's why here f is replaced by 1 by t. So Em sin 2 pi by t into t, or I is equal to Im sin 2 pi f t is equal to Im sin 2 pi by t into t. Okay, so it is seen that induced EMF varies as sine function of the time angle omega t. And when EMF is plotted against time, a curve similar to the one shown in figure 11.3 is obtained. This is the induced EMF curve. This curve is known as sine curve. This curve representation is known as sine curve. And the EMF which varies in this manner is known as sinusoidal EMF. So such a sine curve can be conveniently drawn in this figure, in this waveform. Okay, so a vector equal in length to Em is drawn. Okay, so it rotates in the counterclockwise direction with a velocity omega radian per second, making one revolution, while the generated EMF makes two loops or one cycle. Okay, so the projection of this vector on the y-axis gives the instantaneous value of the E of the induced EMF, that is Em sin omega t. See, this is the sinusoidal EMF or sinusoidal curve of the induced EMF. This is your omega t axis. X axis is omega t axis, y axis is EMF axis. So this, in this position, we have the maximum or peak value of induced EMF, that is represented by Em. Similarly, it is from 0 to pi, and in the same way, pi to 2 pi in the reverse direction, we have the induced EMF value in the reverse direction. Okay, so from this, the sine curve is projected. See, here this is the coil. Let assume in the above diagram, this diagram is similar with the above diagram. Initially, the curve is presented in this horizontal x-axis. Then the coil is rotated in omega radian per second, and it makes theta angle with the x-axis. That's why now in A dash position, our coil is in this position, and here its induced EMF is Em sin omega t. Okay. So if we project this to this y-axis, then we found this point. Okay. Then when this part is whenever here, then if we project this amount, that means this value, the point is found here. Okay. The point is here and the point is here. And when this coil is in this position, then if we project this, then the point is this one. Okay. And when the coil is in this position, then the projection point is this one. Similarly, when the coil is in this direction, the projection point is this one. So if we join these points, we have this positive half cycle of sine curve whose peak value is Em. So similarly, when this coil is in this direction or in this direction, in this position, and we project this, we found these two points. And when the coil is in this position and if we project in y axis, then the point is here. And when the coil is in this position, then the projection point is this one. So if we join this, we found the negative half cycle of the sine curve. Okay, so this is the total one, this total curve is the one cycle. Okay, so to construct the curve, layoff along x-axis equal angular distance OA, AB, BC, CD, etc. corresponding to suitable angular displacement of the rotating vector. Now, direct coordinate at point AB, CD, etc. Then the project of the free ends of the vector EM at the corresponding positions A dash, B dash, C dash, etc. to meet these ordinates. Next, draw the curve passing through these intersecting points. So the curve so obtained is graphic representation of equation 3 above. This is our equation 3. So for this equation, we have found this curve. Okay. So this is our sinusoidal EMF curve or sine curve. And this is the expression of induced EMF and this is the expression for induced current. Okay, so this is all about generation of alternating EMF and current. Okay, thank you.